the one that.
William is a really easygoing dog, man. Yeah. I'm talking about you, yeah, man.
Look at him, he's looking
at getting up on the couch.
He's not
done pretty weird. Maybe it's me. Maybe I get him barking.
Curious about.
So you only have two going back. The little one went. Yeah. And the other people that I thought were going to come in for ginger didn't show up. I'm not terribly surprised. You know, and the funny thing was, is I knew you were doing it. I should have just turned this way, but I didn't.
Maybe. So I'm putting these up here so you don't forget.
Right next to those bottles, please. Y'all think that's a bottle, but...
Huh?
Yeah.
She had a male last week or the week before, and I think he got adopted, and now she's got a almost 6 year old white and red female. She's lived with a male, and now she's being with a female. So makes her a little more flexible.
We never let the fosters in. When we foster, we do foster fairly often. We're still having right now. We never let them go very slow.
Here's how I used to explain it when I was in my old position at PACC. I would say to people, this dog is, I'm telling you the notes, and based on those notes, he should be a new dog. However, within 2 minutes of meeting somebody, I'm going to know if they're going to be somebody that can handle a dog like him, or it's going to be somebody who I'm going to scare them into not wanting this dog.
Right.
And that's what I would do. I would very rarely would I ever have to say no. If I wanted it to be a no, I would just steer them to the no. Like, yeah, you see what he's doing right now? Well, this is what you can expect. Well,
yeah.
And it usually works. Very rarely did I have to have that confrontational conversation. But there are a lot of those dogs. Like Leo, at PACC, they would have told people he has to be the only dog because he's a complete different kennel. He lives with three dogs, and they got along like that right from the very beginning. We had, like, no really awkward, a couple, sideways looks, but nothing, that turned into anything. But it 100% depends on the environment, other animals in the home, and the people. That's where the problem usually starts and stops, is with humans. Like we're talking about this morning. So.
Yeah, I'm really glad we dropped him. And if it weren't for him, I don't think we would have done plenty of the work that we do now. Like, we've fostered so many dogs.
What do you thought, you?
I mean, we have been there. Well, we did also bring it up to him right after we had to ask, right after we got first week, just to help.
That's totally what I'm expecting with Chocolate. She wanted to stay as a foster initially, and I'm like, I told her, the second you get to the first inquiry, you're going to be like, yeah, she's not good. That's usually how it works when you take these foster children like this.
Chocolate doesn't need anything, right?
I mean, she still needs to be spayed.
Oh, she does
need to be spayed. But I told her, I said, you're going to get that first inquiry. But the thing is, she might not, because that picture is pretty intense looking in her. You know what Chocolate looks like.
Yeah.
This is her. I'll show you the color.
What are your other dogs?
We have three. We have a boxer mix. We have probably a bitmix, a chihuahua mix, and some sort of red healer.
So I told her, I said, if this is the picture they'll leave on the website, I said, so
you won't get any.
Just let it ride. Nobody's going to. Well, she looks so intense. She looks like she's built like her.
Yeah.
That's why when she came off the van the first time, or no, she rode up with somebody last week. That's what it was. She was here on a Sunday. She came out, and I'm looking at this dog, and only because of all the spots, because there's such distinctive markings, I'm like, well, it's got to be the same dog, but it was nothing like that.
Yeah.
It was not, she was a waddly thing with a little short, nubby tail. Not what I expected coming to the store at all. Yeah.
I love them pretty chill. I mean, they are, but they aren't. They're used to us fostering, the little pit mix. She's old and she just wants to be left alone. Yeah, she doesn't want to fight. She doesn't want to play, except for with the small dog at the house. That's the only dog she really wants to play with. But she will, as long as she's left alone, she's totally fine. But even then, I still like just a very slow intro. Because I always like to be safe. So.
Yeah, breaking a dog like stuff. Not fun.
Well, our dog, the one who passed away that we adopted from PACC, was so good, but he,
Yeah,
that's
cute.
Yeah,
that's cute.
Right.
Yeah.
Are you there?
What's yours?
All right, Dr.